Okay, so today we are going to look at issues. I have not defined issues in my mind very well, but it has to do with things that are urgent, things that stand out, that show us where to play. And George is with us today, and he's does the recording, and when I get out of line, he puts me back in line, presents questions that I may miss. So let's get started. This is me as white playing against a 5-cube bot. Of course, I'm supposed to win easily, but this is all about the thinking. Okay. We're looking at the white stones. So there's a small issue here. The issue is there's only one place on the board where we can get an advantage, a 2-to-1 advantage. So if I play in the upper right, I've created a one-on-one situation where Black now has the advantage to do what he wants, start a direction, a situation. But in the bottom left, I have that situation. So it can be seen as a little bigger to play here. I hardly call it an issue, it's just something to think about. Okay, we play out the Joseki. Now we have an issue. White's alive in the corner. But Go isn't about being alive, but rather being healthy. If we don't respond, we're going to get constrained and limited, right? So if we play away and he comes down, we're crawling on the second line, he's getting the outside. So the issue is we want health, not life. That's why Joseki comes out and Black comes out. Okay, we look around for issues. If White does something like this, I see no relevance other than a one purpose move of it's big. Here's something. Black can start growing the left in something that looks like Sente. The left isn't interesting. It's low, it's flat. We don't really care, so hard to call it much of an issue. The big one is here. Black's doing a great deal on the right in one move, and his left side somewhat supports the center. So that's something we can consider. It's not urgent, but we like the idea of getting rid of it. So I came in here. If we decide to play this way, this is perfectly fine too. But I'm thinking I don't want Black to get it carried away, so I came in. George, any questions yet?
No, the only observation is that black C10 is a bit too close to those bottom three stones, right? So the second move is one further.
So George is talking about this move, and yeah, generally speaking, if we choose this Joseki, we extend to C10 or D10, third or fourth line, and if we push it one further, then we can push this one further. This is all true, but we do see this as in the game a lot. It's
Okay, with stronger players as well.
I've certainly played six and seven dons that play this move. I don't consider it. When they do that against me, I'm like, oh, I feel like I have a little bit of an advantage. Proving that advantage is beyond difficult. So, yeah, this might be game losing if we're playing against AlphaGo. Who knows? So, something of a mistake, but really quite small. I come in, and again, it's not a problem to play. Oh, I'm on the wrong button. There we go. This is not a problem to play this way. I come on in, settle my group.
And presumably white wouldn't want to come into the 3-3 in that corner because white would end up with a flat position on the bottom.
Yeah, that's worth looking at. Let's compare A to B. The big thing to see is that C is low and settled, so the idea of playing there is ridiculous. Well, what about here? Pretty ridiculous. The bottom is now smaller, which includes B. And just we'll finish up this thought. Black's 4-4 stone likes extending. This is a big area. But the white stones hate extending. So this is a really small area. So the triangles are big, the squares are small. So we consider the bottom to be half and half. So at this point in the game, it's just not interesting. While on top, white and black both want it. So it's extra big.
Another thing is that, so as white, I would never play at O3 now because of the strong C group. But
Right.
actually, but we have a larger than a 5-space extension on the bottom. So if you look at it that way, then perhaps maybe it, in one sense, it could be okay.
Yeah. I would be comfortable playing this move. Well, that might be a bit of an overstatement. Can this move be played and not be a loss? Yeah. For instance, let's say you just take the corner. A lot of times that's a bad idea, but check out what happens. Now we've got the corner. Sorry about that alarm. We've got our corner. That's nice. Black has a wall facing an area that's not too interesting. So there's ways of dealing with all this, but
My fear
since
would be that black would contact that stone and make me play many moves on the bottom as white.
like this.
Yeah.
Right. So I would not want to choose this Joseki, because I'm now need another stone on the bottom, really wasting my time. I would not want to play this Joseki because I don't want to build that area because it's doesn't need anything. So I would go this way and not go towards my other group. Instead, take the corner again. So as long as you stay away from your other group, you can play here, but it's not popular at all because the other places are just so easy and big. Right? What's wrong with that? That's huge. While the bottom is not so much. This was easy to play. Now, a player might play here because, yes, this is not the biggest area, but I think I can play this better than my opponent can. So I'm daring my opponent to try to punish me. A lot of times, a strong player will pick a fight, saying, "I'm going to outfight you," even though it's not a good fight. I have this strong memory of playing an 8-Don in an open section tournament. And on move 10, he played a Joseki that I know was wrong. I checked it out with pros. It was the wrong situation. He just should not have done that. And so I punished him for the next 100 moves. And after that, I just couldn't keep it up. And he ended up winning the fight. It was an epic game. I have such a strong memory of it. Man, he was strong. Okay, so he could care less. A lot of strong players could care less about right and wrong. They're here to fight and outfight you. So, once again, I come in. I settle my group. Settle my group. I have the right to play away here, but there's nothing special. So just settle my group and sente. Okay. One last big area, opening area, that's up top here. I go in there, settle my group. Now, that's all I need to do in that corner. A lot of times we push one more time, but in this case, black doesn't care if we honey. Black will just play some big move. And this, the right's just too small and flat for this to be interesting. So it's not a threat. So no need to play it. Okay, I see two issues on the board, and this game's all about seeing issues. Issue one, we have something that's close to double sente at A. If white plays it, starts bothering that black group. That's worth looking at. If white plays it, the stone's now alive. Well, you gotta admit that's scary for black. Black doesn't like that. I think black can play away and be fine, but we see this is a powerful move for white. And similarly, if black plays it, there's some sente value. I don't need to respond, but I probably would respond. So that's one issue, is A. The other issue is black has a big wall and his area one could easily get out of control. So you can try to get a sense of which issue is most pressing. And when I see that wall and black is prepared up on top, I'm going to do that right away. So in I come. Reduce it with the shoulder hit. All sound good, George?
Yeah, I'm just thinking the fact that black has that almost sente move against your that group in the your group in the corner, perhaps that makes playing such a shoulder hit more difficult for you because you have that slight liability. But if you fix
Well,
the,
let's take
if
a
you
look.
played the one space now instead of this move and made sure that that would never ever be an issue, then perhaps.
Right. So let's check it
Yeah.
out. White plays this way. Black says, "Yeah, I see what you're talking about, but you're not going to hurt me." So black gets great profit. You got a little bit of profit to come in. And he just connects. He
Yeah,
just
nothing much
connects.
happens. Yeah.
I mean, it's just, yeah, white did something good on the left, but black did something great in the center.
Is
Now, I'm
that
just making up moves, right? Just to see the general picture.
Okay, sure.
Yeah. So that's why I come on in. And shoulder hit is very safe and common. So now I can either make a committed group, which I think is okay. But I went a little faster and made a light group. I think they're both fine in this case. We follow our regular pattern. Now there's two issues. I have two cuts. I have to decide which one. Well, the one near the wall is the important one. New issue. This would be very harsh against white. So we need to deal with that. So the atari is very natural. And now I fix my cut. A couple ways to fix it. They're both fine. I just fixed this way. I like being near this future issue of A. That's why I decided to fix this way rather than B. Not sente. If I do nothing, I'm alive comfortably. But black just reduced my corner and gained something on top. And if I stay there, I gain the corner and he's left with a bunch of cuts. So he wants, so it's double sente. So I just finished it up because it was double sente. And now we have two issues. And there's three things to look at here. First, let's talk about area one. Wide open, it's an opening move, but there's nothing, no reason to say, oh, that's important. Yeah, it's big, but there's nothing outstanding about it, just a regular move. While a move like A hurts groups, creates vital points along with the size. So A's an issue and B's an issue. It's again virtually double sente. So which A or B, which one's more important? Well, my center group, that's the one that's going to be hard to develop, that can be attacked easily. So that's where I start. Now, I can't sit here and say B is better than A. No, I'm an amateur player. We're just here to look at thinking and why a strong player would play a certain way. Hey, I get them both. Wow, that's huge. If I'm black, I could not allow white to get both. White plays one, I play one. Sure, he gets the Atari. Okay, you got the Atari, but you only got one of the big moves. I got the other one. But black gives me both, and being just 5Q. Black plays here. Now, all Q players are going to respond because they've been taught that's what you need to do. But why? Is it big on points? It's a couple points, you know. Black gains four, white gains two or three. I mean, it's, you know, 5+ points. But as we'll see in a minute, white's group is just fine. So it's not really sente. So I'm looking at the A spot. And we've got the bottom area. I think they're both fine. But A is a middle game move, and B's an opening move. And we're in the opening. So the habit would be play the opening moves in the opening, and middle game moves in the middle game. That may sound incredibly simplistic, but I was probably four down before I learned that, and it really helped me to get a stable game is to play the right move at the right time. In this case, it's extra difficult because let's imagine white playing here. We see that white can have some issues here. I mean, yeah, we can run away, but we're being attacked. We have a new weak group. Well, if we put it here, aren't you going to have a new weak group? Well, what if we put it here? Well, that's a really slow move. And there's still issues, still Aji there. And what about here? Black can just live. So it's difficult to think clearly about playing at the bottom. I think it's the right move, and we'll talk more about it in a minute. Okay, white. Black plays here. And now we get to see more clearly. This is what I read out at the time and why I felt it wasn't sente, because in this position, I've got a clear eye in area one. I can make a second eye just by some, you know, two eyes. So I can live. On the outside, I'm thick, which means I can get a second eye pretty easily in a lot of different ways. And I can also, to heck with eyes, just run away. So this group has lots of options. That's why I didn't think it was sente when black came in the corner, and I still don't think it's sente now that black finished the corner. Does that all make enough sense, George? Okay. The bottom's still big and is still opening. So I came in.
Was going to say what I like about that K4 move is that it has a nice follow-up.
It has a nice next move, and black is being somewhat bothered now. Remember, black has a sente move here. Black comes in. This is where it gets difficult. I played without thinking, and it all went fine. But it could have got very complex. So let's handle this. Let's try to think this through. Can we connect A to B? At the time, I'm thought, duh, of course I can. It's not so easy to read out, and I'm actually not connected. So if I thought clearly, oh, I may not be connected. That means I want to run out to safety. So I run out to safety. Q players are uncomfortable with this. I'm uncomfortable with this because I'm not creating points. I'm not really attacking anybody. I'm simply running away to where? It's unclear to Q players. But it's also very easy. So I'm not being clear here, but the point is, this move I don't think is that good. And we'll see what more in a minute. Okay, black plays here, all settled. No problems. It all worked out. But what if black comes down? If I capture the stone, I'm very split, and now my corner has issues. If I Atari first, that would be fantastic. But what if he sacrifices the stone? That's horrible in my corner. So there's lots of issues here. And this would be difficult to maneuver. Which is why, if we just play this way, much easier. Very clear, white's out. Black needs to do some sort of connecting home. And we can just have a very easy group. But, so I would consider this that I made a mistake here. But he didn't punish me. Okay, I need to fix my cut there. If I can Hane, notice there's a weaknesses there. This is better. Sente opens up a cut against black. A nice, powerful move. But I had to read something out. Let's look at what I read out. Oh, sorry. I need to kill. Here's what I had to read out. What happens when black runs? This isn't that hard of a read, but for Q players, it could be demanding. Who wins the battle? Well, the liberties are pretty easy to see. Black wins, white wins the battle. But I had to get all that clear before I went that direction. If that's too much, then just save. That's fine. And that's important. Just, it's your responsibility. Take care of your groups. Err on the side of safety. Okay. All done. Groups are all good. Which leads us back to A, because we finished everything, except for one little issue, and that is a double sente move at B. If white plays B, remember, black never responded to our M3, so B can start some problems. And it gives white thickness and strength. If black plays it, black is so out, and now we're flat. So I thought that was important to start first, a double sente issue. He does respond, and that lets me get back to that other move. So hopefully, when you see this game, you're starting to define what's an issue. You know, open skirts, weaknesses, vital points, big walls that can do great things, weak groups, things you need to respond to. And then this game kept it simple and did that. White needs to run home. There's two ways to do that. If I thought my A group was weak, which I don't, then I would run home that way to give it extra strength, right? Now white's way stronger. But I don't think that. So without reading anything out, I just, okay, I'll connect to the corner because corners tend to be bigger. Is it bigger in this case? I don't know. I didn't consider it worth thinking about. They're both good moves. And I went in what I considered an obvious direction. Ooh, what just happened? Black just played in the area where I have a bunch of weaknesses. You got to perk up and make sure everything gets handled. We want to kill the cornerstones, those black stones, and we don't want to leave weaknesses. So I did it that way. That cleans up weaknesses and clearly kills black. That'd be a good move for a Q player to find. The Q player is going to play this way without thinking, and all of a sudden, Atari, and Atari, and down, and like, yeah, white's not dead, but gosh, that's a big invasion. Okay, so I went there. Okay. So we look around for issues. We know that the A-B fight, A's behind enemy lines, B's behind enemy lines, it's a liberty race. Well, white's going to win. Black has no eyes and can't get an eye. White has an eye and can get two. White can run away. Black can't run away. So white's going to win the fight. But black can force white to take, splitting things. And so because of white's weakness, even though white wins the battle, it's still a weakness. Black can use that. So that's an issue. And the only issue. So I went there. Keep it nice and clean. Okay. White's fine everywhere. Black's fine everywhere. But a new issue has arisen. Black has a big old area one. If we're not careful, that could develop into 20, 30 points. So we want to negate it. We want to get as close as we can and as long as it's safe. Shoulder hits tend to be very safe. Very hard to surround the move like that. That'll be safe. We can get home easily. I went this way thinking if he tries to cut me, then I get home easily. So I kind of felt that I had me eye here. One home or the other. And I like how it grows my little center area. But there's any way you do it is fine. All make sense, George?
Yeah, okay.
Here's another move where a Q player is going to play this way. Because they see the Atari coming. But you have to ask, is that an issue? Black says Atari, we save. What's the big deal? It's nothing. What is something is one of our Mii left. We got to connect our stone home. Or just imagine if we, I'll put it here so we can see it clearly. Oh, that white stone could get in such trouble. So connect home. My first thought was to connect here, unknown shape, but this could get cut. That bothered me a lot. So I switched to here in my mind and realized, you know, that can get cut too. So I had to go, we generally consider this the vulgar way. Just as straight arrow as possible, just this one purpose move. But I couldn't see any better shape. So I connect home. He does his Atari. We have to ask, is that Sente? Quick readout. No, white's fine. It's not Sente. But it raises another issue. Not only can black create points here, but when white takes it away, we could capture the two stones. There's Aji to invade the top. There's a lot going on here. Now, we could say, big deal, I'll just go about negating your wall. And that's fine, but this has more to do with groups. Boom, boom. And now it's just in-game. So I get back to the other one. And we see white has created an issue of his own in the center. That can get very big. And that's the only thing left, and the game will end with that. White gets whatever he wants in the center. Let's just look at some possibilities. A is great, B is great, C, D, E is fantastic. But I went in a very boring way. I just went that way. Last opening move. There is some question when black plays here. Yeah, I'm going to live. Yeah, but can he force me to live? Can things get uncomfortable if I... So I said, I don't want to answer those questions. I'll just get nice and strong. It's a big move. And go ahead and mess with my center. It's hard to... I mean, yeah. So I just went real basic. I end up with a solid 30 plus point lead, and that's it. I hope you all caught this idea of issues and how to see and respond to these when you're during a game.